दैट इज द फोर्थ वन. नॉन एम्प्टी सेट. सो दिस नॉन एम्प्टी सेट मीन कंटेनिंग एटलीस्ट वन एलिमेंट इन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज ए नॉन एम्प्टी सेट. सो हियर अ सेट मस्ट कंटेन और कंसिस्ट एटलीस्ट अ सिंगल एलिमेंट इन इट. सो और एल्स इट मे हैव व्हाट आई से वन और मोर देन वन. सो बट एटलीस्ट व्हाट आई से इट मस्ट हैव वन एलिमेंट इन इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ नॉन एम्प्टी सेट. सो हियर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर नॉन एम्प्टी सेट इज ऑफ अ सेट कंटेनिंग at least one element in it. In it mean in the set is known as non-empty set. So here the condition is B is any non-empty set. So here let us write one condition here. The condition is of set B is a non-empty set. That implies, so here set is denoted by means of the letter B. So here if I write equals to phi, but we know phi is nothing but an empty set, but here it is non-empty, that is not equals to an empty. So phi is not equals to empty, that indicates phi is a non-empty set. Then now next one, that is the fifth one, singleton set. So here singleton set indicates a set containing exactly one element in it. So it must have only one element in it, then it will be said, it is said to be called as a singleton set. So here a set containing exactly one element in it is said to be a singleton set. So that means, so it must have a set, must have particularly only one element in it, then only it is said to be called as a singleton set. So here let us consider one example. So here I am going to consider this set as C. So here in brackets there is only one element, that is 5. So it is a singleton set. So here number of elements present in this is of 1, that is 5. Therefore this will come under the C is equals to within brackets the element as of 5 is a singleton set. So in this case number of elements, so here number of elements equals to 1. There is only one element, that is nothing but 5. Hence it is called a singleton set. Next one, that is the sixth one, sixth fundamental concept is of cardinal number. Is the cardinal number of a set. So here cardinal number of a set is nothing but the number of elements present in that particular set. Here in the previous case I say, I wrote here the number of elements present in this particular set are of one, therefore it is said to be called as a singleton. Therefore, this one indicates the cardinal number of this particular set. So here, the number of elements present in a set is said to be the cardinal number of that particular set, is said to be the cardinal number of a set. For instance, if A is any set, then the cardinal number will be denoted by N of A. So here, for instance, if this A be any set, so we are going to consider this set as A. If A be any set, then the cardinal number of this particular set A is denoted by N of the number of elements present in this particular set. So here this gives us the cardinal number. N of A will give us the cardinal number. So generally, when a set is denoted by means of here A, then the cardinal number of that particular set A is denoted by means of the symbol called N of A. That indicates number of elements. N indicates number of elements present in this set A. For instance, that is, for example, let us perform here one illustration. That is, set B, the elements are of 0, 7, 8, 1, 6, 11 and 5. So here number of elements in set B are of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are of 7 in number. The first, the least one is of 0. So 0, 7, 8, 1, 6, 11 and 5 are the elements of this particular set B. So here I am going to write the cardinal number now. So here cardinal number of set B implies, so here cardinal number generally it is denoted by means of N of here A when the set is of A, whereas here set is of B, cardinal number of particular set will be denoted by means of N of B. So, N of B is equals to, that is nothing but the, as per the definition, is nothing but the number of elements present in it. But here the number of elements present in this particular set are of 7. So, therefore, the cardinal number of this set of B, that is set B is of, N of B is equals to this 7. Then later we will go for equal sets. Then now seventh fundamental concept under part 1 is of equal sets. So under these equal sets, let us consider two sets, that is A and as well as B. Those two sets are said to be equal unless and until if each and every element of set A is also the element of set B. That means both sets A and B must have the same number of elements with same quantities. Hence those two sets are said to be called as equal sets. Then we can write mathematically as A equals to B. So here I am going to consider two sets, say one is A and the other is B. Two sets A and B are said to be equal unless and until the every element of set A is in set B. That is, so each and every element of set A are also the elements of set B. So both sets must have the same elements. So and every element of set B is in set A. Each and every element of set A must be the elements of set B, similarly vice versa. That is, every element of set B also must be the elements of set A, then only or hence sets, those are of A and as well as B. So here A and B are called equal sets. So then only these two sets will be called as the equal sets. So as per the definition, we have assumed the two sets as one as A, the other as B. So here these two sets A and B will be equal unless and until the each and every element of set A must be the elements of set B, and vice versa, that is each and every element of set B must be the elements of set A. Then only these two sets are said to be called as equal sets. Then mathematically, so here we can write mathematically as now. We can represent mathematically as equal sets, that is A and B will be equal. So we can represent by A equals to B, that is mathematically.